My name is Fred Monje. I'm coming from the One Health Platform, and I'm also a fellow with the Uganda Public Health Fellowship Program. So I'd like to share with you what One Health Platform has done. This is mainly from the government side. What has been shared has been mainly from the university side. But as government, there are also initiatives which has been done to show that we embrace and appreciate One Health. Looking at what is within our environment, you realize that we cannot afford to live alone. We cannot afford to simply say, let's eliminate those species from our environment. But the key question should be, how should we live harmoniously? And the best way to live harmoniously is to embrace One Health approach. Briefly, that one shows us the One Health zone, that many sectors are involved and each has a specific role to play. We cannot say the other is more important than the other, but we are all working for optimum health of animals, the environment, and then the humans. So once we appreciate that, it means One Health will be easy for us to apply in our everyday work. To give you a background, One Health in the government sector is not something new. As far as back in 1980s, it was already embraced. And this was evidenced through the establishment of the Veterinary Public Health in the Ministry of Health, and also the establishment of the Uganda Trypanosomiasis Control Council, which was established in an attempt to control sleeping sickness, which was a big problem at the time. However, the challenges which continue to be posed by the endemic diseases like rabies, like brucellosis, and emerging diseases like the highly pathogenic influenza, like the Ebola's, you know, and then the anthrax, you know, it made us realize that we needed to have to strengthen these coordination efforts, because it was leading to a loss of lives and then unnecessary expenditures. This need was realized indeed when all these sectors came together, that is Ministry of Agriculture, Ministry of Health, Uganda Wildlife Authority, and Ministry of Water and Environment. They came together to realize and look, we need to form structures to help us operate together. And indeed, One Health framework was established. Another document was the MOU to specify the roles of these different sectors and partners in operating the One Health approach. And eventually this led to the launch of the National One Health Platform in November 2016. That is simply the organogram of the National One Health Platform, whereby we have the secretariat, as it's called, Zoonotic Disease Coordination Office. Sometimes we call it One Health Coordination Office because we are embracing also other issues like the AMR, because it's becoming an important issue of recent. Then we also have the One Health Technical Working Group. Those two operational levels are what forms the National One Health Platform. And it's key to note that this platform is headed by directors of these sectors on a 6-month rotational basis. But the secretariat runs the day-to-day activities. Actually, it coordinates, but the actual work is done by the sectors in partnership with other stakeholders. How does it operate? Since the launch of this platform in 2016, we've had a number of achievements, one of which was the prioritization of zoonotic diseases in 2017, which was a big challenge to us. Using a CDC tool, for the first time, we're able to come up with 7 zoonotic diseases which are prioritized as a country. 2, we also developed the strategic plan 2018 to 2022, which is guiding how we are training different stakeholders in applying One Health in their daily activities. Not only that, but we've also developed preparedness and response plans such that we don't aim at only at response, but also prepare before the actual problem occurs. And this has been mainly in support with the different partners like FAO, like WHO, like PNR, and several others. We've also developed a communication strategy. And then in the recent past, we've also come up with established structures at the subnational levels, particularly at districts. And we've started with the districts which have had outbreaks like highly pathogenic influenza in 2017. We've trained districts around central Uganda. We've also gone to West Nile to establish structures of One Health because anthrax was a big problem, but also other diseases. So we've trained One Health approaches in that district to help them coordinate and ensure that there is early reporting, early detection, and then of course early response. Now, another thing is it has also helped us to coordinate sample collection, because initially sample collection, especially from these weeks which were far away from the center, was a challenge. But through partnerships and collaborations with Ministry of Health and other partners, now sample collection from far away districts are no longer a challenge. They can easily reach the reference centers as soon as possible. Not only that, but even the testing, testing as well has been now very key, because, and this has been very possible through the partnerships and then collaborations. Then remember, it has been the one platform which has mainly coordinating these approaches to ensure that we have early sample transportation and then quick testing of the samples to take action. In terms of emergence, we've been utilizing the existing structures to respond, like the Emergency Operation Center, which has already been there, the National Task Force, which is already there. So we normally operate in collaboration with all those structures, and indeed, since the establishment, we've made a lot of progress towards that. Another thing is, when it comes to the operation itself, we have a systematic way of operating through establishment of different subcommittees so that we can move systematically, and we define different roles as listed there, like the coordination, surveillance, case management, and communication plus others. So we have a systematic way of how we respond to these outbreaks. And finally, much has been operating like this, we've been having some few challenges. However, as a platform, we've come up with the way forward, and the way forward is to develop what you call a One Health policy. Now, this One Health policy, we're already drafting it. This one will help us, will help the sectors to annually allocate resources so that it can help the platform to continually do preparedness activities. Not only wait for response, but to continually do preparedness activities, because when you prepare well, it means we can minimize the outbreaks we have. I'd like to thank you for listening.